Before I begin, I want to let you know that this new feature is only available for commercial subscribers of Autodesk Fusion. I'm sure that many of us have faced the following situation before when creating a sketch, especially when it comes to complicated sketches. We try our best to go through every nook and cranny of the sketch, but we are simply not able to figure out why the sketch is underdefined. It often comes down to a single missing dimension. This is where the new AutoConstrain feature can come in handy. We have a very simple example here. We have a sketch rectangle studied off to the right of the origin. The length and width have been defined. We have defined the horizontal location of the rectangle with respect to the origin. In this case, it is quite obvious that the rectangle has yet to be constrained vertically. We also have an existing solid with one of its corners projected. Let's go to Automate, Auto Constrain. The tool picks up on the missing dimension and suggests the dimension in purple with respect to the origin. Suppose that we want to dimension from the corner of the existing solid instead. If we click on the three dots, we can see an option to set datum. Click on that and select the projected point. The suggested dimension will now take reference from that corner. Any dimensions created this way can be changed as it would a normal dimension. Let's draw a random looking shape. I'm going to draw this line as straight as I can, without actually snapping it perpendicularly. If we engage the auto constrain feature, we have the ability to generate more suggestions. If we scroll through the suggestions, you can see that the command basically goes through different combinations of angles and dimensions. If we see a dimension that we do not want, we can delete and refresh. The command will try to offer an alternative suggestion. For me, the biggest disappointment of this new feature is that it does not actually add constraints. In this case, it does not actually recognize that I am trying to draw a vertical line here and add that constraint. In this example, I'm trying to draw a tangent arc to the horizontal line here. For the sake of discussion, let's ignore the fact that we are able to snap this tangentially and draw this in a non-tangent way. If we use the AutoConstrain command, we can see that it is not able to guess our design intent and add the tangent constraint. If you have sketched splines before, you will know that they are notoriously difficult to dimension. Let's see if we can use the AutoConstrain feature to help us. Let's draw a fit point spline in space and AutoConstrain it. It looks like all the spline points have been fully defined. What about the spline handles? They are still underdefined. What I have found is that you will need to activate each spline handle individually before applying the AutoConstrain command to define them. So do be aware of this. In conclusion, the new command can be a good way of quickly detecting any missing dimensions. They can also be useful in quickly defining a sketch when we are doodling a rough design. Just don't over-rely on the command and expect it to interpret your design intent. Do try this out and let me know your thoughts.